Thank you for watching, and in this video I'm gonna cover how to work with slicing tool. So as you can see, like on my screen right now, I have a 17th lecture here. So I have a first file which is STL file, which is normally used for the 3D printers. But right now I want to bring the STL file into the solid, and then I want to show you how you can use slicing tool. So when I have selected 8.17 STL file, as you can see here in the file type, then you can see there is an option button which is options. So I'm gonna click on that, and then you can see like how I want to open my file into SolidWorks. Do I want to open like a graphic body or surface body or a solid body? Suppose I want to go with the graphic body, and then I'm gonna click OK, and then I'm gonna open this file into SolidWorks. Yes. Okay. So as you can see, this is my graphic body, the one which I want to bring into the SolidWorks. So I want to change the color. Let's say we can just change the color. Suppose we want to make it blue. I just want to make it more visible. Okay, so we have a blue body here which is only graphic. We don't have a solid, we don't have anything, as you can see, just graphic. Okay, so on the feature manager I can go into top plane, and then I would go into the insert here, and then into the insert you can see there is an option slicing. So in the slicing you can see I am gonna slice on the top plane which I already selected, and then number of planes to create, like how much many slices I want to have, so I can increase, and I can cover the whole body like this. And then there is an offset. If you want to have some kind of offset, still you can have an offset as well. And there are some other options like add slicing planes and sketches to a folder. We can create a folder and add them. Or there is another option, preview slices, which I would like to check. So we can preview from these points, it's going to be sliced. And there is another option, exact. So we don't care about the exact dimension, so we can just uncheck it. So in this way, it's going to save some performance of our laptop. Okay, I'm gonna uncheck this, and then there are other options like we can have a boundary box or in whatever the directions, but we don't care about them. So I'm just gonna click the green check mark. So here you can see we have a multiple slices, as you can see. Okay, now what we can do is under the feature manager into the slices, you can see there are planes and sketches. So what we need to do is I want to select all the sketches, sketch one, and hold the control key on my keyboard, and I want to select all the sketches. Okay, as I already selected all the sketches, and next what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna lofted it. So I'm gonna go into the features and into the ribbon section, I'm just gonna lofted it, and you can see like already all the profiles are here. And now we need to select the guide curve. So what we want to do is like I want to have all these green spots on one direction. So there is some problem here, so I can just pick these points and move them. I don't know why it happens actually. Okay, so you can see roughly I bring all of them into one line. So what we can do is now we can just apply our loft command. So I'm just gonna click the green check mark. So as you can see now, we have a graphic body as well and one solid body as well. In the feature manager, you can see into a graphic body is here. We have one graphic which we inserted it or imported it. And by using a loft command, we already made a solid body. Okay, so if you want to see it clearly, I would say let's hide the graphic body. Hide it. And now we have our solid body, as you can see. And we can sketch or whatever, or we want to edit feature or whatever we want to have, we can apply on this body, because this is not any graphic anymore. This is a complete solid body now. So look, there are multiple ways, like if you can bring us STL file or any external solid body, so which is not a part of SolidWorks, and then you can just slice it, and if you want to make it solid, you can just made it solid. And that's all for today's video. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this one. And if you are a serious SolidWorks learner, then don't forget to check the course link in the description. Thank you.